Welcome back. Well, let's bring in now Sky News contributor Gary Hardgrave and LNP Senator James McGrath. Welcome to you both, gentlemen. Let's turn to the cost of chicken. Now, you know the cost of living crisis is biting hard when sales of chicken fall dramatically. This is meant to be, and I have to say I don't eat chicken myself, but this is meant to be the cheapest and most popular protein for Australians. This is according to the Oz newspaper. Gary, you know, there's a lot of grocery products that people just can't afford to buy anymore.
You know, Sharri, if you don't eat it and I don't eat it, and Australians on average eat 50 kilos of chicken a year, there must be some people doing a lot of work for you and me. Look, it's very rare we
why
have
don't,
chicken.
Why don't
in
you
our
eat
household.
Chicken, Gary? What's your excuse?
It's not my first choice. I'd much rather have a good piece of red meat and some great seafood. So there you go. It's pretty simple. But chicken is the mainstay for a lot of people. And, yeah, the cost of living crisis is coming home. But the problem here is that McDonald's, KFC and the people that cook chickens are not affording the cost of the electricity. That's the problem, Sharri. And all the big retailers, all the big commercial fast food stores, everybody is feeling the pressure because labor is so hell-bent on driving up the cost of electricity. So, yep, going to come home to roost, as you say.
Yep. James, I think there's a section of the population that are really struggling just to put food on the table, you know, kind of close to poverty during this cost of living crisis. But then there's another whole section of Australians who are just actually cutting back on a lot of grocery items because inflation, you know, has pushed up the price of just common things and it's not going back down.
Food prices under Labor have gone up 11% in the last 2 years. This country is in a cost of living crisis. Now, I love chicken, and I'll take your 50 kilos, another 50 kilos
off
Gary.
Good to hear it. Go for it.
I genuinely adore KFC, but seriously, there are families out there, their treat is on a Friday night is to get KFC.
Exactly.
And if people can't afford KFC, it shows there is a real problem in Australia, and that is because we've got a Labor government, and as Gary pointed out, they're driving up the power of the cost of power, sorry. They're driving up the cost of living just generally, whether it's insurance, rent, mortgage and whatever. People are cutting back, and it's because of Albanese.
Exactly.
Yeah. Now, Donald Trump held his first outdoor campaign rally since the assassination attempt. He had to do it behind bulletproof glass. Have a look.
That charade that they have going on. They mentioned my name, I think, 271 times. They mentioned the economy like 12 times. They mentioned the border, maybe none. They don't talk about the border. Our great border czar doesn't talk about the border. But they mentioned me more than any other category. I'm now a category. They had me down today as a category. That's all they talk about. Trump. We've driven them crazy. They have Trump derangement syndrome.
And Gary, of course, he was speaking there about the DNC. But it's true. Their focus was more Trump than any policies.
Yeah, because Trump is the guy that's standing between the insanity of more of this green left climate con internationally and getting ourselves back on track. And frankly, Australians will be better off if Donald Trump can completely pierce this mad green dream about renewables being able to give us enough electricity to cook that Kentucky Fried Chicken that James seems to like so much. Look, you know, Donald Trump has got to get out there. And if he's taking any sort of advice from security people to be behind plexiglass, I tell you one thing it does do is it emphasises the fact that he is a big threat to the elites and to the establishment all around the world, and people are going to be out to get him. This bloke will broker a difference if he can be elected. So keep him safe, keep him bottled up. Well, I don't think you can keep him bottled up, but keep him on track and make America and the rest of the world great again, I say.